I know you like that. Would you like a little bit of it? At least a little sip? I know, I see that you feel cold. You have about 4 blankets on yourself. So, I thought this might warm you up a little bit. Like more. You can keep it, it's all for you. Okay. I'll just like put it there, okay? Great. So, what's happening? I know I've been kind of noticing it the whole day. Which one is it? Or is it both? Right. I know. You may not notice, but I notice. I see everything. When are you going to understand that? You know what? Tonight you don't need to do anything. I'll just take care of you and, well, you know what? Tonight is your night. You don't need to do anything. I'll just take care of you, okay? Because I think it's been a long time no one has taken care of you, right? I know you never tell me, but I kind of like to, you know, I think the me time is so important. So, we'll just make sure that you have a nice, relaxing time, okay? And then you can go to bed and just think about something else, okay? Tomorrow is going to be a new day. You don't need to care about it tomorrow, today. Probably tomorrow, though. Do you? Right? Okay. So you just stay where you are in your bed. I'm going to just put the blanket on you. Okay. It's a very warm blanket. Are you okay? It's not too warm. Fluffy. I actually really like the sound it makes. It's really relaxing, sort of. Just make sure you're all tucked in, okay? I told you, you don't need to take care of anything. not too tight. Alright. What can we do now? I just want to make sure that you're not sick, because earlier you mentioned you may have a fever, right? So I'm just going to check. No, you don't feel so hot. It's okay. All right. Great. Yeah, we better make sure that you're not sick, you know. So apparently it's just a mood. Don't worry. I'm a professional. Says makeup primer. You probably don't wear makeup, right? I never, like, I rarely see you with makeup, so. But it's good for skin, I think. So why don't we just, oh, look, it says it hydrates, illuminates, blurs, unifies. brush your hair and then we'll take off the mask, okay? Alright. So, don't. Thank you.
Thank you.
which one is the best for you. Do you want Rapunzel? Let's see. Page 88. Oh, that's gorgeous. Here's an image. Rapunzel. There were once a man and a woman who had long in vain wished for a child. At length, the woman hoped that God was about to grant her desire. These people had a little window at the back of their house from which a splendid garden could be seen, which was full of the most beautiful flowers and herbs. It was, however, surrounded by a high wall, and no one dared to go into it, because it belonged to an enchantress who had a great power and was dreaded by all the world. I love this. Where was I? Oops. She was dreaded by all the world. Where was this? Oh, there we go. One day, the woman was standing by this window and looking down into the garden when she saw a bed which was planted with the most beautiful Rapunzel. And it looked so fresh and green that she longed for it and had the greatest desire to eat some. This desire increased every day, and as she knew that she could not get any of it, she quite pined away and looked pale and miserable. Then her husband was alarmed and asked, What aileth thee, dear wife? Ah, she replied, if I can't get some of the rampion, which is in the garden behind our house, to eat, I shall die. That's very dramatic. The man who loved her thought, sooner than let thy wife die, bring her some of the rampion thyself, let it cost thee what it will. In the twilight of the evening, he clambered down over the wall to the garden of the ancient, hastily clutched a handful of rampion and took it to his wife. She at once made herself a salad out of it and ate it with a much relish. She, however, liked it so very much, that the next day she longed for it three times as much as before. If he was to have any rest, her husband must once more descend into the garden. Himself down again, but when he had to clamber down the wall, he was terribly afraid, for he saw the enchantress standing before him. How can thou dare, said she with an angry look, to descend into my garden and steal my rampion like a thief? Thou shalt suffer for it. Ah, answered he, let mercy take the place of justice. Necessity. My wife saw your rampion from the window and felt such a longing for it that she would have died if she had not got some to eat. Then the enchantress allowed her anger to be softened and said to him, if the case be as thou sayest, I will allow thee to take away with thee as much rampion as thou wilt. Only I make one condition. Thou must give me the child which thy wife will bring into the world. It shall be well treated, and I will care for it like a mother. Magnificent.